Hey guys, welcome in Core Java interview question and answer. In this video tutorial, we are going to see a practical example of one of the very important interview question. And here is the question. How would you sort a collection of data based on two properties of an entity in Java, which is analogical to SQL's order by first field, then second field, and thereafter that you can specify DESC if you want to perform sorting based on the descending order, or you can specify ASC. By default, I think ASC itself, ascending order. So how this kind of situation or this kind of scenario you can implement in the Java code itself. So let's try to understand through a Java code itself. So here is the Eclipse, and I have already created an example, and there I'm going to show you how we can achieve this kind of coding, right? This kind of scenario. So here I first of all I show you my model class. Here I have a person class with four fields: ID, name, first name, ID, age, first name, last name. Yeah, I have a basically constructor which basically initializes all these instance variable, public getter method, and finally I have overridden two string method so that I can display or print a state of object in nice format. Yeah, now here first thing is that how we can sort a collection of object, right, based on the two properties. So here basically sorting based on the multiple objects properties is easily achievable in Java collection framework. We just need to redesign our comparator to accommodate for multiple fields. So let's see how we can achieve that. So here you can see I have created a comparator class, right? Name I have given person, sort by age and name, right? So here this class basically implements comparator interface, and I have overridden basically compare to method, right? So in this code snippet you can see the implementation for person comparator, basically whenever age of two person is equal, then return the result based on the name, I mean first name comparison, right? So here you can see if I find age of two persons is same, then sorting is happening based on the first name, right? So in that manner, in that way, you can have some conditional sorting based on the more than one properties using comparator, right? If age of first person is less than age of second person, then this is going to return some negative number. Here I have returned -1, but it's not mean that you have to return -1, any negative number you can return, right? Else this is going to return 1. Yeah, now how we are going to use this comparator, right, in sorting of a collection of a person, right? So that's the thing I have written in the client program. So I have a person, right, person list. There I have added few objects, person object, right? In real scenario you can have just you are populating these objects from the somewhere from the data source, right? Now here collections utility class is having a sort method. There I'm passing this list of collection, and after that you have to pass comparator object, right? Empty comparator object, which we have just defined over here. Now when you iterate this collection of object, then you'll find basically sorting will happen first on the age, and then if age of two person is same, then sorting will happen on the name itself, right? So let's try to run this application and see what's the output. Now if I run this application, then here you can see person is basically sorted based on the age, but here two persons is having the same age, 30 30, right? Then then sorting is happening based on the first name, right? Now same, let's say I want to achieve same functionality using Java 8. So achieving the same result in Java 8 is compact and easy. Let's see how we can achieve that one, right? So that's what I have written second client program. Here how we can achieve the same using Java 8, that's the code I have written. Yeah, so here again we have a list of persons, and what I am doing, list of person dot sort, right? This sort method is defined in somewhere in the list interface, right? So directly you can call. And if you look at the sort method, it's a default method which is added in Java 8 itself, right? So we are calling sort method on list object. Yeah. Now comparator basically comparator is added, right? Comparator has upgraded in Java 8 with a lot of basically methods. So comparator is having a comparing method, right? It's a static method. Directly you can call by interface itself. Yeah. Now here you don't need to basically when you achieve the same functionality using Java 8, then you don't need to basically define a separate comparator, right? Without this you can suffice, right? So here you can see the implementation. What I am doing, person of list dot sort, then comparator dot comparing, and first comparison I want to do based on the age, right? If 2 person age is same, then comparing method is there. So directly you can come. So if you look at the comparing basically returns you the reference of comparator itself, right? That's what we are able to call. We are able to make a method chaining. Then we can call the another comparator method is called than comparing, right? So what you are telling, I want sorting should happen first on the age. If two person age is having the same, then we want comparison based on the another properties that is called get first name. And don't be surprised, this is a basically method reference. It's a one of the properties added in the Java 8, right? This is so directly person class name and double colon and get first name you can see. If you want sorting to happen a third property, then again you have to call than comparing, and again you can specify the third property, right? So basically this line of code is nothing but the sorting is happening, and finally we are just displaying list of object using Java 8, right? So here you can see that's the magic of Java 8. It's compact with lambda expression and functional interfaces. If I run the application, you'll get the same output exactly. Yeah, so here you can see 2 person is having the same age, then sorting is happening based on the name itself, right? So same result we can achieve through Java 8, but it's really compact, and that's the magic of functional interfaces and lambda expression. So guys, that's all I have in this video tutorial. I hope you enjoy learning this video. So let's meet in the next video tutorial, and thank you so much for watching this video.